guy, Greg Moody.
Give Diane another hand. All right, well, I'm Greg Moody, another middle-aged white guy. You know, I know Christmas is over, but I've solved the Christmas present problem. And once you get past buying presents for kids, Christmas is about breaking even, that's it. You don't want to look like a jerk, or you don't want to blow a lot of money buying presents for people that you don't really care that much about. But I got it figured out. Next year, I'm going to get a stack of those gift cards you can put any dollar value on, and put nothing on it and give those out. And then I'm going to activate it with exactly what they got me. Or hope they stick it in the drawer and forget about it. Okay, but I do like buying presents for kids. Because, you know, they like anything you give them for about the 4 minutes it takes till they break it.
Oh, yeah, I do that.
And so I was trying to get presents for the kids on my list, and I searched Amazon for girl toy. And up pops life-size and realistic silicone sex doll. Yeah, on Amazon.com. So I freak out. And I look and make sure nobody's watching. I close the window because, of course, I'm doing this at work because you wouldn't want to use personal time doing shopping. I still need to finish them. So I try something else. I try Toy for Girl. And guess what? Amazon sells a wide variety of vibrators, too. So my first thought is, I'll buy a sex doll, but I sure as hell ain't going to get her a vibrator. So, you know, I finally give up shopping for the day. But you know how when you're online and you look for something like a blender and you don't buy it, and then all of a sudden all over the internet you see ads and deals for blenders? Well, sure enough, all over the internet I saw sex dolls, vibrators, and somehow they think I'm in the market for anal beads and something called a spandex full body binder sack. Those are expensive, somebody said. Somebody knows. Yeah, but I'm freaking out because I don't want anybody to see this. So I Google how to stop sex toys on the internet. And all I get are more articles on sex toys, and now I can't watch Netflix without being educated on which dildo is best for an evening out. But then I thought, well, if I buy it, you know, buy some of these things, maybe it'll go away. So I bought the next thing that popped up, and I had it shipped to somebody else anonymous. I didn't think Grandpa would figure it out was for me. His vision's kind of bad. It turns out he enjoys the fully lighted monster dong. He uses it as a flashlight when he walks a dog at night. But then it still didn't stop, and I got an email from the company asking me to review the product. So I thought, okay, if I write a scathing bad review, they're going to stop. It's going to stop. So I wrote a terrible review. They sent me a lifetime supply of vibrators and a letter from the president of the company. We want to keep you as a customer. So finally, I put this knowledge to good use. There's a guy at work I don't like, so I went on his computer and searched Amazon for head lice shampoo and wart remover. See what happens to him. But speaking of sex, I was really worried about having the sex ed talk with my son. But it was really easy. He already knew everything. The internet. And he taught me some stuff I didn't know. It turns out I probably shouldn't have waited until he was 16 and had a kid on the way. See, my dad had the sex talk with me when I was 6. And all I said was, Dad, why do girls have different bathrooms? All of a sudden, he turned into Bill Nye the Science Guy, the star of his own Disney TV show about sex. See, he was a teacher, so he had books, like from 1952. I still remember the books. Naked men and women shown in the most unsexy way possible. Sure, I still masturbated to them, but hey. And I was really way too young to understand any of this stuff. But he was a teacher, so he got the chalkboard out. And he drew stuff, and there were charts. Even to this day, I have to look at a Venn diagram before I can get an erection. And I still have to teach my son stuff, like I have to teach him how to drive, because I lost the will to live. He's really not that bad, I just have to remind him of things once in a while, like, for God's sake, put on the brakes. Please keep it under 95 in the school zone when there's children crossing. That was a human being. And I just have to point out things once in a while, like, maybe we ought to go back and check to see if they're okay. I don't care if she's a bum. Recently, a police officer pulled us over and asked him if he'd been drinking, and he says no, and then he turns to me and says, sir, have you been drinking? No. May I suggest you start? I have a pint bottle in the car for just these circumstances, because I had to teach my kid to drive myself. No, somebody likes that. Okay, well, thank you very much. All right. And that's my part. Up next, we're going to really like the next comic and the last comic of the evening. Give a big hand for DJ Payne. Yeah.